this drawing that you've made on the site, on the
yeah.
map. It's a pretty steep hill. How do you account for that? Do you like have to grade back into the hill to?
Well, I think they'd already would have graded it for the building.
Okay.
So yeah, it would consider it all part of where.
You mean right here?
Yeah, it's like it's pretty steep.
Yeah, that's why I mean the lane might actually be literally just another 10-foot lane that they have to dig out of the hill and make. That's just a big challenge because the there may be utilities under there, for example. Maybe it's no deal for that. What is the move utilities, move sewers, etc.
And that's why I was thinking if you could go through the property.
Yeah,
one thing,
you
could
go
even
up.
If you create a lane, it's not still going to traffic backs up there. It just isn't efficient in a place where traffic already backs up for BT to try and keep on schedule.
John Eustace and I were talking. My wife was from Duke Land Trust, and I was visiting a few weeks ago. He said, so what do you do about all the traffic? Because we've changed from...
What are you going to do?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Or be in the town, whatever. Because we changed 8 months ago from two lanes to one lane, right, in this area. And so what's happening is it's... And there probably is more traffic, too, but it feels like more traffic because people are slowing down and it's bottlenecking earlier than it used to because of that change. So if we don't add an actual lane here, it's going to be... Can't really do it, especially if you have. I mean, you could do it, but this is really popular. You have 40 people getting on a bus. That could literally take 2 or 3 minutes.
Yeah, what he's talking about is it used to be that you could stay, that there was a left-hand turn lane, and you could stay in the left-hand lane on Main coming towards the university for longer than you can now. Now it pushes you over. You either have to make the left-hand turn,
back.
It pushes you over into the right-hand lane. So it's technically one lane of traffic. Traffic because of that one lane, and then we went from two lanes to one lane at College Ave, right? We narrowed that, so we've done all this in terms of traffic calming, which is great, but if people don't take advantage of things like the bus, it just means that we have to figure out how to get the same number of cars through on fewer lanes of the road, and it impacts your ability to maintain your schedule.
Sure.
It's like you said, you know, you can make a turn, but that's going to add route. If it does that, then the route no longer is every 15 minutes.
Main Street's a 26-minute route, and it takes us 35 minutes. That's why Main Street's late, often. Construction, traffic, etc. Another question?
Are there
staffing is a big problem. We get requests all the time for Sunday service. I want to go to church. Okay, well, most of our drivers are going to church, too. And there's, 60 churches in the whole region? I mean, there's so many places to go, and they all start at 9 or 10 or 11. So that's just one simple example. Saturdays, we have less service for various reasons. It's not as popular. Saturday night, we still have a lot of service, obviously, for safety reasons. I always say we're the biggest designated driver program in the state. That's good. And then we only have 6 full-time drivers. All the rest are anywhere from as low as 9 hours a week up to, 56 hours a week right now with a lot of overtime going on. So most of our drivers are part-time, about a third are students, a third are retirees, and a third have various jobs. We have a few faculty members actually that work full-time for tech and also drive for us. That should really answer your question, but yeah, the weekends are just challenging in general.
And then game days when service kind of stops.
Every bus we have, 50-something buses are out. People are getting paid overtime. A lot of the full-time drivers won't drive because they can't or they've already done their 40 hours and they have other things to do. But it's pretty much all hands on deck for driving. And we literally, first few weeks of school, we had managers and supervisors driving buses, which is not sustainable. When you have a bus driver making $10 an hour and a manager making whatever they're making, $20 to $30 to $40 an hour, that budget-wise, you just can't do that. But when there's no one to drive, you either cut routes, which we have done some, cut some service, or we pull managers to drive. I don't drive. I ride my bike.
The bus is way bigger than your bus.
Yeah.
It might be dangerous.
I always joke that I learned how to park my bike, so I shouldn't drive a bus. Did I answer your questions? I'm not sure if I'm getting enough detail, but one more question about that.
How far into Pulaski County does the bus service run?
Our bus service does not service Pulaski County, but Pulaski Area Transit does. You have to go online to look at the actual routes. They have what's called deviated fixed route. So they have basically six stops that they run sort of regularly, but then they deviate as far as a mile from those stops by request. And then now, just recently, it was a pilot program. It went, I think it just ended, but I'm not sure if it's continuing or not. They have a new director. It goes to Christianburg Mall, Newton Mall. So we can transfer, in theory, to our stops from there.
Well, thank you, Eric.
Yeah.
And if any of you have questions that you think of and you need to come up and talk, you want to ask,